Welcome to the CFA Connections how-to tutorial on serving wine. In this video, we'll provide basic wine service standards, as well as discussing various types of stemware, the types of corkscrews and foil cutters available, plus service tools such as a serviette, also known as a napkin, serving tray, beverage napkins, and an ice bucket, which you may or may not have on board. Enjoy. The type of wine glasses in which wines are served is very important, as the shape of the wine glass can impact the taste of the wine. And for this reason, different types of wine are served in different types of glasses. Now, that being said, on board business jets, the options are usually very limited. Many new aircraft these days are now outfitted with two types of wine glasses, and of course, this is based on the type of aircraft and the storage capacity, and the sizes and shapes will vary greatly. However, in reality, the majority of business jets will only have one size wine glass. One, and it's usually small. So we do what we always do and make it work. One thing to note, if a client requests a high profile wine, it is recommended to seek approval, if required, for supplying the proper stemware to enhance your client's wine experience while in flight. Always the wow factor element. The corkscrew. If you are a contractor, the variety of corkscrews you will find on aircraft is endless. Some are great, some are good, and some are, well, instruments of torture. This is why you may want to carry your own in your service kit if you're an independent contractor. The most popular corkscrew is the waiter's friend. It's also referred to as the sommelier knife or wine key. There are two types of waiter's friends, the single hinge and the double hinged. We recommend the double hinged version, and I will demonstrate how well this works when I open a bottle later in the video. The waiter's friend is basically the jackknife of corkscrews. It features a comfortable handle, a double hinged fulcrum, which basically means a level rest, the corkscrew. It also has a bottle opener, and in the handle, a serrated foil cutter blade, which nests in the handle. If you're using a corkscrew without a foil cutter, you will need to use a separate foil cutter tool. These also come in a variety of types, and some definitely work better than others. I'll talk more about using these foil cutters along with a demo a little bit later. Let's briefly talk about wine serving temperatures. Many people serve red wine at room temperature. So I ask, what does room temperature mean to you? There is a lot of misinterpretation regarding serving wine at room temperature, especially in America. If you're serving wine literally at the temperature of your room, most likely you're serving it way too warm. Room temperature for serving wine does not mean the temperature in your room, but rather wine cellar temperatures, which are a bit cooler, running 59 to 64 degrees Fahrenheit. According to Wessett and the Court of Masters, white and rosé wines should be served between 44 and 55 degrees Fahrenheit, and red wines served between 54 and 65 degrees Fahrenheit, so much cooler than you probably realize. Now, on board business jets, there is a limited amount of ways we can chill wine. Most of us have to either use the ice drawer or the cold storage compartment. Many newer aircraft have wine refrigerators, however, the temperature accuracy is not always possible. So again, we do the best we can do. A general rule to achieve best serving temperatures for in-flight wine service is as follows. With red wine, take it out of refrigeration or the ice drawer 30 minutes prior to serving. This will allow it to warm up closer to an optimum serving temperature. White wine, place it in the refrigeration or ice drawer no less than 30 minutes before serving, ideally an hour longer before serving to ensure the proper temperature. Presenting the bottle of wine. If a wine was specifically requested, you should always present the bottle to the VIP or whoever ordered it. If the client simply asks for a glass of red wine or a glass of white wine, obviously they don't really care what the type is. But it's always a nice touch to provide them with your selections and then present the bottle prior to serving it in order to confirm it's what they ordered. You present the bottle by cradling it at a slight angle and lower so the label is facing the person at their eye level. The bottle can be naked or flanked with a nicely folded linen napkin. Either way is appropriate. Just make sure the label is facing them. You want to give them ample time to review the label, as they'll be checking the name and type of wine, the appellation, and the vintage. Megan, the Fox in Flight, goes into label reading in great detail in the wine pairing tutorial video. Okay, opening the wine. This tends to be very intimidating for many cabin crew members. Now, unless the flight operation requires you to open the bottle as a tableside service, open it in the galley. This is much safer, less stressful, and significantly reduces the risk of spills in the cabin. The galley is your safety net, so use it. I'd even close the cabin door if you can. We're back now to using the foil cutter tool. First, why do we need a foil cutter? The majority of wines have a capsule, which is a foil sleeve which covers the top of the bottle. Wineries place this foil capsule for two reasons. It protects the cork and keeps it clean, and to create a fetching look for their bottles. Wine etiquette states you should remove the capsule so the wine doesn't come into contact with the foil while pouring the wine. Therefore, you need a foil cutter. These tools are completely fine to use, but you need to make sure it cuts the capsule low enough to prevent wine from coming into contact with the foil, as the wine will automatically take on that metallic taste, which is definitely not what you want to happen. Most foil cutter tools cut the foil just under the top lip of the neck of the bottle, which is fine. Now, using the waiter's friend's corkscrew, use the foil cutting blade and rest it against the bottom of the neck lip of the bottle. This is your guide to cutting the foil. Rotate the blade around the lip with a steady and direct pressure to cut the foil, and then remove the top part of the cut capsule. It should appear clean and neatly cut. The corkscrew worm, such as this one, the coiled point is not dead center, so when placing it into the cork, you want to be just a little bit off-centered. Avoid being too close to the edge of the cork, as you can damage it while removing it and end up with a bunch of broken pieces from a perfectly fine cork. Rotate the corkscrew into the cork until you reach the first hinge level. This is the benefit of using a double hinge corkscrew. Secure and pull it straight up and you'll reach the second hinge level. And continuously with the same straight motion and the cork will release easily. Once released, check the appearance of the cork. It should be intact and spongy to the touch. You may present the cork to the VIP, and they will also do the same. FYI, smelling the cork really doesn't tell you anything. Make sure your stemware is clean with no fingerprints or worse. And when pouring the wine, especially red, use a serviette to catch any of the drips. In the galley, this can be a paper towel. Here I'm using my drop napkins because they not only look great, they are disposable. Side note, before pouring an aged red, you should wipe the inside lip of the bottle to make sure there is no sediment there. And when ready to pour, you can eye it or use a counting method to pour equal amounts into multiple stemware. If your stemware is cut crystal, you may be able to use the design as a reference point for equal pouring amounts. I'm pouring here to intentionally create a few drips, showing you why you always need to use a serviette. Yes, there are pouring spouts and drip stops available too. If you have them, definitely use them. When using a serving tray, as you should, never carry more than two wine glasses at a time. This allows you to use the thumb lock method to avoid spillage by securing the bases while carrying them on your serving tray. Emplacement for a wine glass during a meal, on a business jet, basically anywhere you can make it work. As long as the client can reach the glass without having to reach over a taller glass, should be fine. As an alternative to tableside service and the impending potential for spills and clanking and chipping of the stemware, Megan the Fox in Flight shared this great tip with me and I've recreated it here as an example. If you have a vacant table in the cabin, you can use this as your wine pouring station. So it's a spin on tableside service on a business jet. You can place a nice serving tray with a bottle of wine. You may or may not have a wine bucket, but if you do, use it. You'll include stemware, your corkscrew, a small ramekin or plate to place the cork onto, and a serviette. This allows you to have a safe place for pouring the wine in the cabin. I love this idea. Another trick she shared to help control the temperature of the wine and using an ice bucket in the cabin, use ice gel packs cut to fit into the ice bucket. You definitely do not want a bucket full of ice water in the cabin. There are way too many potentials for disaster there. Now, we easily could have gone into much greater detail on all of this, but we want to avoid these tutorials from being too long. Plus, these are intended to cover the basic standards to establish consistency. Rely on the training you receive and the flight operations procedures, but you always have this video as your reference guide. As always, thank you for watching and let us know in the comments if you have any questions or your own pro tips to share.